So both supporters of the two major political parties, the NDC and the NPP, believe that their candidate has won, really. But what's the Electoral Commission saying? Well, it was expected that at 5 p.m., the Electoral Commission would do the declaration. But that did not happen. The Electoral Commission has come out to explain. We would tell you exactly what the Electoral Commission has been saying. But so far, it says it has received results from 14 regions out of that seven have been certified. The remaining seven results are going through certification process, and they've assured that they will release those results when they're duly certified. So the results still outstanding in some areas in Bono East and Northern. There are certified results from the Volta region, Northeast, Central, Ahafo, Upper West, Oti, and Bono. And the outstanding regions, Ashanti, Eastern, Western, Western North, Upper East, Greater Accra, and Savannah. So I'm just quickly going to run you through some of the areas certified by the Electoral Commission as they spoke to the media yesterday. So here are results from Bono. And per what the Electoral Commission has released, and this is the presidential results, Nanado Dankwa Akufo-Addo garnered 292,604, and John Dramani Mahama has 203,329. So that's in the Bono region. Now, if you go to the Oti region, it puts Nanado Dankwa Akufo-Addo as 103,865. And John Dramani Mahama has 181,021. So that's the Oti region. From Oti, we go to Upper West. Nanado Dankwa Akufo-Addo has 121,230. John Dramani Mahama has 238,972. In the Ahafo region, Nanado Dankwa Akufo-Addo has 145,584. John Dramani Mahama has 116,485. These are certified results as released by the Electoral Commission. In the Central Region, Nanado Dankwa Akufo-Addo has 613,804. John Dramani Mahama has 538,829. From the Central Region, we move to the Northeast Region, where Nanado Dankwa Akufo-Addo garnered some 122,742, whilst John Dramani Mahama had 112,306. In the Volta Region, Nanado Dankwa Akufo-Addo got 100,481, whilst John Dramani Mahama got 606,508 from the Volta region. So that's what has been released by the Electoral Commission. But here's what Jin Mensah, the chairperson of the Electoral Commission, said to the media yesterday, explaining why the declaration could not happen as she had promised, 5 p.m. on Tuesday.
So thank you very much for coming to the commission at short notice. We thought that it would be important to meet with you, to brief you on some issues that have arisen during the course of this evening. And I'm referring particularly to the Commission's inability to declare the results as planned at 5 p.m. today. I think the Commission had intended and had indicated its intention and willingness to declare the 2020 presidential election at 5 p.m. today. That is within 24 hours after the general election. However, we experienced quite a number of challenges, making it difficult for us to fulfill this promise. And what had happened was the unexpected rain that occurred in many parts of the country yesterday resulted in a number of voting interrupted. And the result was this: that long after voting, some centers had to continue their voting, and this led to some delays with voting and the subsequent collation of results. Naturally, this had an impact on our plans in the sense that our officers could not collate the results and forward them to the appropriate locations as planned. Secondly, we also experienced some challenges with the rain, and particularly in some of our areas in the hinterlands, but Western North to be precise. It was difficult for our officers to travel to the regional capital and to send the results there. So this led to some substantial delays, resulting in our receiving the results late. And this explains why the commission was not able to, you know, release and declare the results as promised at 5 p.m. today. It's important to emphasize that the process is ongoing. As we speak, the commission has received 14 out of the 16 regional results. We have the National Collation Center, where we've had representatives of the political parties since yesterday. We have two reps for each party, and they are working with our own staff. As the results come in, the party representatives review them against what they themselves have received from the regions. And once they are satisfied that the results that have come to us from the regions is a true reflection of what they have received, they then append their signatures to it before the results are brought to my attention. As returning officer of the 2020 presidential elections, I then certify these results. Out of the 14 results received, we have certified 7 to date. To this point, we believe that by the end of the evening, we would have certified the remaining 7. We are expecting to receive the 2 in the early hours of this morning, that making up the 16, and then it will put us in a good place to declare the results. We've also put the 7 results that we've certified, received, approved, and certified on the various social media platforms and the website of the commission. So we are treating the citizenry to visit our websites and our social media platforms to review the results of the 7 regions that have so far been certified. It is important to note, and there may have been speculations of some attempts to manipulate the results. This is false. I think the process that we have is a very transparent and participatory process. And I think any interested Ghanaian is aware that at the polling station, we have the political party agents with our officials at the polling station. At the end of the election, at the polling station level, parties then count the results, they collate them, and they document them on the face of the pink sheets, the statement of poll, and the agents of the parties then sign on to this. From the polling station level, the results are sent to the constituency collation centers, again in the presence of the political party agents. And at the constituency collation centers, all the results coming in from the various polling stations are collated and put on the face of the pink sheet and, you know, signed on to by all the agents of the political party. This is a very transparent and participatory process and involves both the electoral commission's officials and the political parties. This year, we have introduced a new level of transparency and inclusiveness. And what we have done is to introduce a regional collation center. So unlike the previous elections where constituency collation results were sent to straight to the National Collation Center here at the head office, constituency results are sent to the regional Education Center. And there also we had the full involvement of the representatives of the political parties. So what happens is that every region collates all the constituencies in that particular region. And therefore, if a region has 20 constituencies, you find on the regional collation sheet the summary, the details of 20 constituency results. Additionally, we also have the regional summary sheet, and you find a summary of 20 constituency results. And this also involves the political parties in the sense that they approve this, they verify the information that is transported onto the collation sheets at the regional level, and they append their signature to it. So this is the level of participation of the political parties, making it impossible for anybody to rig an election. And therefore, if there may have been speculations out there in the public space in the last few hours, we entreat the public to ignore it, because the political parties append their signatures to these, you know, collation sheets, regional collation sheets, starting from the polling station to the constituency and then to the region, before it is sent to the National Collation Center. At the National Collation Center, I believe some of you may have witnessed what happens there. We find you have the representatives of the political parties who, when the results come in from the regions, they review it and verify it against what they themselves have received from their own agents. And once they are happy with it, they append their signatures to it before it is brought to the office of the chairperson for certification. It is only after that that the results are projected on our website or shared with the general public. So this is the level of participation that we see. It is important to emphasize that this year the results are still coming in the good old fax way and by email. And so what we are getting is not just numbers coming through some transmission, but there are photographs and images of the pink sheets and the collation sheets. And so at the National Collation Center, the results that are coming in are the regional collation sheet and the regional summary sheet. All of them are signed by the agents of the political parties. And this is what we have, and this is what is presented to the political parties before certification by the chair. So we thought that it's important to express our regrets for our inability to organize and the declaration at 5 p.m. as planned. This is what had happened, the unexpected rains and some of the challenges that we experienced as a result of the rain, and indeed some challenges that had occurred at the collation center made it difficult for us to declare the results as expected. We are hoping that in the early hours of this morning we would receive two additional results, and we would thereafter be able to make the declaration sometime tomorrow. It's also important, in the past, the issue of parliamentary results was something that was declared at the constituency level. We've noticed that there's been some confusion about the number of seats in parliament, and we assure you that tomorrow we will make this information available to you as to the number of seats in parliament, which party has the number, which number of seats, how many independent candidates we have in parliament, to put the issue of, you know, the number of seats parties have in parliament to rest. We are collating this currently. You know, the information is going out on our website, but this is some information that we'll share with you tomorrow so that we can put that matter to rest. We entreat you to ignore some of the speculations and allegations that have gone out. We can actually give you copies of the sheets as they come in from that come through a channel, as I mentioned, or through some transmission lines. They are just images and photographs of the signed, you know, collation sheets that come from the regions. And these are approved and signed by the political parties. So we thought that we should put this matter to rest and to allay the fears of the public of anything untoward happening. We have received 14 results from the regions. They are currently, they are all at the National Collation Center. The commission cannot certify these results. And it's important to note that the commission cannot certify these results with that, and of course the parties approve it, they take it round for them to look at, and once that process is satisfied, it comes up to the commission. So it's a bottom-up approach where you have parties looking at it and approving it and comparing it to the information that they already have from their agents at that level. And it is after that that it is brought to the commission for certification and made public. So this is the process, and we thought that it would be important to highlight some of these processes to allay the fears of Ghanaians that anything untoward is happening. We entreat you, you are our media partners. Many of you have walked this journey with us and you know this process very well. So we also entreat you that together with the commission, let us educate the citizenry and share this information to those who may not be aware of it. Because I think the peace and of this country should be paramount. And the truth is what should stand at the end of the day. And so we entreat you as partners who have walked this journey with us to highlight some of these issues and to inform the political parties about it. And maybe as a way of enabling you to see what happens, it may be important to share the pink sheets and put them on the website as they appear. What we've done now is to, you know, try to take out the information and put it in templates. But I think this evening, the seven sheets, the seven results that have been declared, we will take those pink sheets, pink collation sheets, and also put them on the website so that it also provides you with some information as to how these things are come about. So we'd like to thank you very much for coming at short notice, and we look forward to engaging with you tomorrow. Thank you very much.
So you have the chairperson of the Electoral Commission, Madam Jean Mensah, addressing the media and explaining why the declaration, as the Electoral Commission itself had stated, was going to happen 5 p.m. on Tuesday, could not happen. Also confirming the results that they have and what the holdup is. So essentially, they've received results from 14 regions. Out of that, 7 have been certified. The remaining 2 is going through the process of certification.